Hi, YouTube. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. So, what I have here is my latest design. It's a Warhammer. I saw this design, something similar to this online that inspired me, and it made me want to model something similar. Now, this isn't the end product here that you see on the screen. The end product looks slightly different as I've tweaked each individual component. And I have two versions of this Warhammer. One that's smaller, about 25% smaller, and it's more of a single-handed design, kind of like Thor's hammer, but with more detail. And then I have this larger model, which is should stand roughly, if you use a long enough shaft, about 4.5 feet from tip to tip. Now, the idea behind this design is when you look at my files on Thingiverse, you're going to see that this piece, these two center pieces here, and this piece here are hollow. And I designed them that way, and they have, they're going to have circular openings inside them. And I designed them that way so that I can fill them with concrete and give them weight. And there's going to be two chambers running this direction through straight through the headpiece, and then one chamber running straight this way. This piece here is not a part of the model. What it is just representing, it's a placeholder representing a piece of EMT conduit. My chambers are 23¾ mil in diameter, and they're designed to fit EMT conduit through them. So you can fit two pieces of EMT conduit through in this direction to fortify the headpiece together. You can use some quick set epoxy like I did, and then another piece of EMT conduit this way with epoxy to connect all these pieces. And that way, even though everything's 3D printed, you have your handle of the shaft and the interior skeleton are all steel, and it's all epoxy together, so the steel gives it some reinforcement. You don't have to do that. You can just print the pieces. You don't need the concrete or anything, and you can just epoxy everything together, and you have a nice little display model. But I wanted something that has some weight and was semi-functional. It's not 100% functional because, again, it's plastic, but it's functional to the point where if I wanted to crush, say, a soda can with it or something a little beefier, I could do that. Smaller design I don't have up right now, but the individual pieces are in their own files, and they can be found on Thingiverse as well as the larger piece. And I do have design files for the end pieces that are solid besides the hollow ones in case you just wish to print this, put a piece of EMT conduit through for the shaft, and then epoxy everything together without any other structural supports. You notice here in the head, I have these sayings, these phrases. This is an unfinished model. As I said, the finished model has a phrase all the way, phrases all the way around, but there are 8 phrases, and we'll give you a quick rundown of what they are right here. Everything's Latin, and the first phrase stands for holding the infinite. The second phrase stands for I know not how to yield. The third phrase interprets let them hate so long as they fear. The fourth Latin phrase, I am not led, I lead. The fifth Latin phrase, I remain unvanquished. The sixth Latin phrase, make my day. You know, a little Arnold humor. The seventh phrase, victus honor. Honor to the vanquished. And the eighth phrase interprets victory or death. Let's get to the time-lapse prints of the model. And then from there we're going to go on to paint and assembly. And then a final look at the finished product. We'll be right back.
my Warhammer design, I designed the headpiece in four pieces, four main pieces, and I designed them to be hollow. And the purpose for that was for myself, I planned on filling them with quick set concrete to give it the weight and feel of a real hammer. So I have these four pieces all sanded up, ready for the next phase for them, and that'll be to mix up some quick set concrete and pour in all the crevices and let it harden, and that'll give these quite a bit of weight. And then after that, I will glue them together. As you can see here, there are two channels here. Those two channels correspond with the two channels on either lion face. And what we'll do there is we'll take some EMT conduit, cut to length to match, and we'll be running it straight through from one through the other with some epoxy to hold it in place along with inside here, and that'll keep it solid, and the EMT conduit will give it rigidity. And along with a center hole for EMT conduit to run straight up the center for the shaft. So I'm going to mix up some concrete here. Let me get a stick so I can mix this stuff up. This is my carpenter shop. It's pretty dirty. I'm just coming off of winter, and usually I store my wood in here to burn through the winter, and it just turns into a big heaping pile of mess. But throughout the warmer season, this is where I do all my woodwork. Almost a roll of plastic. It'll give me another 12 pounds of weight on the head of this thing, not including the EMT conduit that's going to be running through it. I'm just going to clean up here real quick, make sure I got no concrete left on my table saw. Already it's starting to set. A lot of okay. A little bit left there. Clean it off. I'll explain something here. Let me get a close up of something. I'll explain why I did it. So on these I have, get the focus there, you'll see I have the inside printed hole only up so far. It's about an inch from this edge. The reason I did that, so that I have a gap between the concrete that I poured in and the EMT conduit's going to go in there. And so I have a place to fill with a quick set epoxy when I put my EMT conduit in, and I'll fill the gap between the concrete and that. So we're going to let these sit for the next 48 hours. And then we're going to come back to them. We're going to get all our parts together. We're going to clean them up, and we're going to prime everything. So what I'm going to do is these three pieces here, I'm going to epoxy them together on here so that they hold their shape, and then I'm going to set them aside and dry and get everything set up to do my prime, first coat of primer. And when these are dry, you see I got a little bit of a gap here because these warped a little bit on the bed, so I'm going to use a little bit of body fill there, or maybe the epoxy. I'll squeeze enough out to fill that gap. We got some 5-minute epoxy. We're going to open up here and mix. Okay. This is just Dollarama brand 5-minute epoxy. It's pretty cheap stuff. It's only $1.50, and there'll be enough in there to do these three components here. Everything else will be at a later stage once I've got all my EMT conduit. Pretty thick stuff as well, so it's good for when you're bonding parts together that have little gaps that need to be filled in and stuff like that, and you want something that'll set up pretty fast. I could probably set this up just to print in two parts instead of three, but I wanted to design it for as many types of printers as possible. And remember, these are scaled down 75% because my original intent for this was to be a much bigger pole hammer. Okay, all my pieces have a first coat of primer. Now, I did film this, but the battery died in my camera during the filming process, and I lost the video. So, we have our first coat on here, and we're going to do a second coat. Our epoxy held up really well. And we're going to do a second coat here. Once the second coat is dry, we can do some more prep work. Take this guy, flip him over. So I can. Oh, these guys are quite heavy. The concrete's starting to harden up in them. I'm going to flip these over so we can give a good coat of primer in here. So we're going to do up this top piece now. I'm going to coat my two pieces of EMT conduit. I'm going to coat the, give a liberal coat of epoxy to the outside edges right here. So I'm going to need a new mixing board. Here's the head of our hammer. Let's get a closer look here. I'm gonna have like a three-tone thing here. I'm gonna get some simulated chrome paint for here and here. We'll have some pleather, fake leather banding all around here.
This is the final color for here. It'll gradually get darker into here. And then the lion head is going to be gold. There. Now we just have to wait for that to set up. Okay, we got most of the paint done. This gold really turns out well. I really like this gold. This is, I found this paint at Canadian Tire. It's Krylon 18 karat gold plate, it's called. And it goes on really thick and really smooth. Most of the chrome or gold simulated paints, I find they wipe off after you with your finger, or they don't look realistic. But this stuff, just shines, and it doesn't smudge. It doesn't smudge, doesn't come off. And it goes on, and it goes on thick, like this was applied with a small skewer. I still have to get some simulated chrome plate, because these tips, as well as this tip, this edge and this edge here, are going to be simulated chrome, which will really spread out this spectrum of color that I've got going here. And same with this tip and these tips, and then my 8 little spikes. I want to get a simulated chrome paint on those. So, for the most part, the paint job is mostly complete.
So now I'm going to finish assembling everything onto a piece of EMT conduit with some 5-minute epoxy. What I should have done is I should have let the tips set up with the EMT conduit here before I attempted to glue everything else together, but I'm rushing this. This is what you get when you rush things. Okay, so I've had this veneer for a long, long time, and I've had to soak it so that I could wrap it around the shaft without it splitting. I'm going to do a piece on each end here. Even with it wet, it still wants to split, but it's not as bad as it was. And I figured my hand will be in there, and I'll wrap that.
Thank you.
So I'm going to do up some epoxy and clean these up. And then glue them, and then wrap it. And let it set. So this veneer is really brittle. Dry like this, I can't bend it. Like, I can't wrap it, it'll crack. But if I soak it for a little while, it gets more pliable, it's better, it's much more workable. curves a better. This one's already got cracks in it from before, but as you see here, there's no cracks happening there. Now, I don't usually do props or stuff like that with my printers, but I designed this model myself, and I thought it would be a fun thing to print it out and make it as realistic as possible. And to do that, I wanted the weight, I wanted the durability, so that's why it's got EMT conduit right from the tip to the tip. Okay, we'll let that set up for about 15 minutes. And then we'll come back to it. I'm just waiting for epoxy to dry on this last strip here. And maybe might do some little bit of touch-ups. We have a gradual, we have this silver. I couldn't get any chrome paint locally. Every place I went was out of chrome spray paint, so I had to deal with this silver. And then I got a slightly darker silver. This is more of like an aluminum, and then a dark silver here, and then I got a mix of silver in the black here. As you can see, I was gonna do these little tips, but it's just right now it's too much work. Maybe at a later time tape everything else off and do these little tips, but for now I just, that's too much. And slowly comes back out into the aluminum-ish color here. Same with the tip. I really like this gold. It comes out nice. It doesn't tarnish or rub off or come off on your skin at all. It goes on nice and thick. Now I did print this at 3.3 mil layer height, so you can see my layers there, but I didn't want it to take forever. My plan was I wanted to design the model and then I wanted to print it. But I think it turned out pretty good. Again here, we got this aluminum-ish silver. And then hints of black throughout the silver. And then this aluminum-ish silver here. I couldn't find any chrome locally. Everybody was sold out of that. So, it's pretty much done. Just maybe a few more little touch-ups. I'm gonna give it a final weigh. See the total weight. That's in a... Earlier, you saw that I filled this thing with concrete. I cleared the concrete out of the center because it was really way too heavy with the concrete in the center as well. Because this piece, this whole assembly here is like 15 pounds right now. And it was just over 20 with the center filled. And so I cleaned that out because it was really way too heavy. I find the weight now is just right for the size of it. It gives it a realistic feel in the hand. I apologize for not filming cutting up the pleather placemat and installing it. I did film it, but unfortunately my battery died mid-filming, and because the video, the MP4, has no header file, I'm unable to restore it or use it at this time. So basically what I did is I got this placemat, this pleather placemat. I separated it from the felt back, and it has it's a nice brown leather texture. I cut it into strips, and I did a starter strip here. I cut it on an angle like let me see if I can show you here. What I did was, I cut it on an angle like such, so that I could get my start here, and then weave around and just have a little bit of an overhang here and have it nice and a straight line around the top. So to do that, you have to find the angle you need here, cut that angle, and then get your starter strip going. And what I did is I coated the back of this with some quick set epoxy. I got it wrapped up so far, and then I taped it up, and then I coated the rest, and I wrapped, and I wrapped and wrapped tightly as I went, stretching. When I got to the center, I taped it up to there, and then I needed to join it. So I got a join seam here because I would have preferred not to. I would have preferred to go right to the end with this, but given what I had here, it's not long enough to go all the way, so I ended up having to do a join seam in the center, basically repeating up here. And then I just cut a couple of straight strips without any angles, and I did a solid wrap here to give me a finish at the top, and I did a solid wrap down here. So that's all I did there. For these two strips, aside from moving the felt backing, there was another backing here, and just with a very carefully with the knife, I stripped this other backing off, and I'm just left with the pleather. So that's what I did here, so you don't see any white. Left the backing on here, and this was just straightforward, cut some thin strips, do one side at a time, let it set up, do the next side, and so on. Again, I'm sorry I wasn't able to show you doing all of that. I did film it, but unfortunately my battery died, didn't give me any notice, and I was unable to recover that video. But here's the hammer. Might be a few little cleanups to do on it. It's quite heavy. It's got some oomph to it. With my mighty hammer, I shall destroy! Thanks for watching.